Hello and welcome to Cobbles Point. I'm just about to explore the new footpath around Cobbles Point, and I'm at the top of Jacob's Ladder. The central Felixstowe Sea Defence Scheme was completed at the end of September, with a new section of promenade around Cobbles Point to link Undercliff Road East with Jacob's Ladder. The total scheme cost around £10 million and will protect the coastline from the pier to Jacob's Ladder. There were already substantial sea defences at Cobbles Point, but these were ageing and piecemeal, and something more substantial was needed. Up until now, the journey around Cobbles Point would have involved clambering over rocks at low tide. Now it's easily possible on foot. However, disabled users and cyclists will be disappointed to discover that the promenade ends at Jacob's Ladder, and the walk onto the dip is along the beach. This section of coast, I'm sure, will be new to some of the more recent Felixstowe residents, and at its heart is a steep flight of steps known as Jacob's Ladder, which has been here many years. Jacob's Ladder. There are quite a few Jacob's Ladders around the country. What's so significant about Jacob or his ladder that steep flights of steps get named after him? Was he some sort of celebrity window cleaner? Well, if you know your Old Testament, you'll know he's a character from the Bible. The long and short of Jacob's story was that he was a cheat. He got the things most important to him in life by subterfuge, and he was happy to even con his own brother out of his birthright and father's blessing. Jacob was from a God-fearing family, but there's no record of him ever having dealings with God until one night he was on a journey, and while he was asleep, he dreamt of a stairway, or ladder, reaching to heaven. And there were angels going up and coming down this stairway. Then he dreamed that God was standing beside him, and God made promises to him that had been made to his father Isaac and his grandfather Abraham. God also promised him that he would be with him and protect him. How did he deserve any of it? He didn't. God reached out to this flawed man. Jacob woke up and perceived that he must have been in a place where God was, and called it Bethel, which means the house of God. Actually, he was wrong. God had already said to him in the dream that he would go everywhere with him. So that meant that God was everywhere, not just at Bethel. Jacob's relationship with God started the day that he realized that God was at this place, and God was going to be everywhere with him in the future. Why am I saying all this? Well, apart from the fact that this is a well-known story in the Bible that has inspired people to name steep flights of steps after him, the message behind this tale is that we don't need to have a holy place to reach God. He's with us wherever we are, whether or not we can sense him, hear him, feel him, or whatever. And in Jesus Christ, there's a connection with heaven, a stairway to heaven. Jesus said these words, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me." Do you want to know God? Then he's here, wherever here might be. He's already reaching his hand out to you. How do we get to him? Well, there's only one way, and that's through Jesus Christ. So next time you take a walk around Cobbles Point to Jacob's Ladder, you'll know where the name comes from. Oh, and in case you're wondering, the Led Zeppelin song Stairway to Heaven probably wasn't inspired by Jacob's Ladder. Asked recently about it, one of its writers, Robert Plant, said he didn't have a clue what the song was about, and he was the one that sang it. Well, thanks for listening, and may God bless you.